The Workforce Investment Board's a group in Erie County that addresses issues of workforce need in the area and tries to implement programs to develop workforce assets that are needed for the future. We focused on biotechnology, mainly because of the medical corridor involvement in the biotechnology industry and the university's 2020 program. And it was realized that we're going to need a lot of people to fulfill the workforce needs in that area. The second area was medical technology, which is a very aging profession right now. And with a graying of the workforce in medical technology, we really have a severe need to fulfill the jobs that are going vacant in this area. We decided to try and incorporate a program that was actually brought to us by Rama De Rao. She came to us with the idea of incorporating the Joint Genome Project gene annotation program into our academic curriculum at the college level. We thought that it would be a top-notch type of program to introduce to actually secondary school students. That blossomed into the current program, in which we've brought back some of the teachers that were originally involved to provide them with some information on how to pursue gene annotation, a field of bioinformatics, and to then involve the students in some actual hands-on exercises.
In October of 2009, we wrote a little application to the JGI. We introduced the concept to them of using high school students and teachers, and they were very interested because there had been a very limited application of this to high schools at this time. One of our teachers, Mr. Lon Knappenberger from Westfield High School, took the program in the first year it was offered, where he had the hands-on experience, and he was one of the ones that jumped on joining the program for gene annotation right away when we made it available. He came to UB in the summer of 2010, where he received the training on how to do the genome annotation using the IMG Act program. Then he went back to the Westfield School District and secured funding from his school district to purchase 20 iPads. And he developed an online tutorial for doing the genome annotation that he developed totally on his own. His students would sit with the iPad next to a computer terminal and using the iPad as a source of information for the step-by-step process for doing the genome annotation and then actually perform the annotation on the computer terminals.
I'm Georgetta Chaveria, and I'm a student at Westfield High School. Not a lot of schools where we live have like the opportunities that like bigger cities have. It's like preparing us for the future, even though it's just in high school. It can help us in college and in our careers that we choose to go to. I'm actually interested in nursing, and I figured doing this type of program would just even help me further in like knowing what I want to do.
On December 18th of 2010, the teachers and students came to UB, where we conducted this capstone symposium, where they set up their posters for display. We had a speaker, Dr. Marnie Levine, speaking to them about biotechnology-related careers in Western New York. The poster session, where they stood and described their posters to the other students and faculty who were attending the capstone symposium. And then we had Dr. Mark Halfon, a professor here at the University of Buffalo, who does research in bioinformatics, give a very nice talk about practical applications of bioinformatics for metazoan organisms, multicellular organisms.
Our idea in going into this particular area of education for students, it's to spur their interest in pursuing careers in that area, that there's opportunities out there. And that's why in our program, we also try to introduce them to other type of technologies that are currently used. There are jobs available in biotechnology firms that are growing in this area, as well as research labs not only at the university, but at pharmaceutical companies and other companies, not only in this area, but throughout the country.